when I used to ask questions to my mother and my father, and my we get into conversations, and it often gets into, you know, a bad one. That's how it gets, right? So my brother and my sister, what they've advised me is, you know, better not talk to them, because what you're trying to do is, if you're right, then they're wrong, and then if they're wrong, all these years what they've lived through will be wrong,
and they have invested a lot in those years, so it proves that all your investment has gone waste, so your life has gone waste,
and so it makes it very tough for them to, you know, just to leave. Yeah.
It is these very simple and obvious things, you know. You say, I put in so much of effort in the last 30 years. Now will you just come and tell me that I was being stupid? It hurts. It hurts. And just to avoid that hurt, you continue living in the same way.
To make people happy, those kind of people happy, and at the same time, you know, live by your life.
But you know, when you look at others falling in this trap, do not think of it as something that happens to others. We are all one. If it is happening to them, it is quite likely happening to you and me as well.
Sure.
So use the others, use is a bad word here, but I'll still use it. Use the others to see your own mind, because our minds are fundamentally the same. So it's easy to criticize others, but to see that you are in the same trap. He might be a victim of religiousness, you might be a victim of some other social propaganda, something that the media has brought to you, something that you know, the corporations, the big industry has brought to you. But we all are susceptible to being conditioned. So one has to be alert in seeing that. Today's religion is very different, you know. We may say that we are Hindus or Muslims or Christians, but the religion today is greed. Information is religion. Knowledge is religion. Corporations, progress is religion. So you have to be equally alert against these neo-religions.
Yeah.
Coolness is a religion, is it not? You have to be cool. Cool. Whatever that means, I don't know.
Yeah.
I've seen that, especially with the young people, their religion is coolness. So you have to see that this religion is equally false. It is very easy to criticize the existing religions, to criticize Islam or criticize Hinduism. Criticizing them is easy. But why don't you criticize this coolness with equal vigor?
Just have the mindset to accept whatever you are following might be wrong too.
Yes, of course. So that there is this inner honesty, this inner openness, and a very uncompromising sense of inquiry. But unless I know what it really is, I will not just accept some nonsense. You are young, it's wonderful. You must not compromise, you know.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
You must not at all compromise. You must be very open, very humble, very surrendered, and you must say, I have one God and I want to know.
Actually, you know, I can't go. If I go tell all this kind of stuff to my parents, they would be unhappy. And that's like, you know, I don't want to make people unhappy. Kind of, you know, making people happy is why you live in the first place.
Your objective has to be the truth. Your objective can't be other people. Neither their happiness nor their unhappiness. If you are moving in truth, guided by the truth, then you are bound to make a lot of people unhappy. And if you say that I don't want to make people unhappy, then you will have to compromise and you will have to live in false. And if you are living in false, you will only become a source of suffering for others. So in trying to help the others, you will only become a source of more suffering for them. So do what is right and do not worry about the results. A lot of people were unhappy with the Prophet, were they not? He had to fight so much. People were so unhappy with Jesus, they
killed him.
Krishna is fighting a war and a huge army is firing arrows at him. Were they saying that, oh, he is the personification of God and we must respect him? He is the charioteer, he is the, you know, with the horses, and people are after his life. So truth necessarily ends up making a lot of people unhappy. You must not bother too much about that. It must not be your intention to hurt anyone. You should not be violent. As far as possible, you should avoid means and methods that rub people harshly. But even after all this, if someone ends up feeling hurt, then you can only just say that it's God's wish. I didn't want to. But what do I do if you are carrying a pre-existing hurt within you? I'm not responsible for that. And I have to take care of the truth first. That is my number one God.